And it being a Wednesday, it is of course, everybody decides to make it a Woman Crush Wednesday. Now today, I don't have a person in particular I want to crush on, but I want to crush on all those women who know their worth. All those women who get up and leave. All those women who just look at something and they're like, yeah, this is not for me. To all those brave women out there who are not afraid to actually understand it's going to hurt, but the farther you are away from it, the less the fire scorches or burns. So those are women I'm crushing on. This definitely. And to all the women out there who have given up on relationships and got yourself a fuckboy, yeah, I'm crushing on you too. It's a very dirty world out here. We're not gonna get into relationships anytime soon. This man is tricky. Hey, see Intebelezayo Abude anymore. Like at first I used to think Intebelezayo Abude, that is the best way to describe a Ugandan man. But I think now we can turn them into global warming. Because global warming, you can't really tell what's going to happen. I'm just saying. I'm Mr. Fierce One and welcome to Scoop and Scoop, your daily dose of gossip. We're still talking about this whole B2C thing because in today morning we were trying to actually reach out to them and have their final words and say, because we saw they put up the statement and they're like, yep, B2C and Under Music are no more, they're done and all of that. But I wanted to call them and ask, like, what caused all of this? What did all of that? Until I heard that this breakup is so on a whole nother level that by the time the word came out that they were breaking up, Under Music was already recruiting new guys. I was like, wait, what? Under, why would you do them cold like that? It's like breaking up with your lover, you know? You expect them to pine about you like for a week, a month, a day or two. But no, not Under Music. No, 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 no. Under Music, and Zevan Soveda, no console. Why your daddy, Ande? Andrew Mugerwa and the Bitsy and the music if you're not. Anyway, rumor is he already has new kids that he's signing onto his label. The boys are moving along. They expected to give us like the full detail in January. But then again, let's ask ourselves. In this breakup, who do you think left the other? Farouk, who do you think left the other? Do you think Ande walked away from B2C or B2C walked away from Ande? You believe Ande events walked away. You know, here's what I see. Both are a synergy that worked really well together. But the truth be told though, Ande is much more likely to walk away than B2C is to walk away. Because at the end of the day, Ande is a businessman. You have to understand that he has fed you, clothed you, done all these things for you, taken you places. And that's business. So I think Ande sat down with all the new, fresh attitudes that the boys are getting, because let's face it, these boys have started catching an attitude. They believe they're that relevant. They believe they're the ish. They believe they should be shaking a lot of trees. So Ande being the businessman that he is, I think he sat down and looked at it and he's like, well, in terms of Muntademumeka, because they came out of nowhere, and by the time they came out, they were burning, like their videos was on fire, their clothes was on fire, like they had a tight-knit thing. So I believe Ande had taken some pity to Munyinji Nyo, and he had to sit down and ask himself, so on returns, I think this was an entirely business situation where everybody's money felt like it wasn't been counted down to the penny. So let's wait, but bani bagenda okusayininga bani atatuletera ku pia mounds sizi ku mounds pounds aina nyimba. At the end of the day, I was actually listening to a couple of people who were talking about this particular incident. There was, and the conversation was management. How hard is it to be an artist manager in Uganda, and how hard it is to actually manage an artist at any given level, not just Uganda. And this is something that I need to delve into. So I think, my boys, we need to get like about 5 promoters and like about 3 managers. And have a sit down, you know, one-on-one. Let them tell us chinechin tubachi kwasa ganyabati. So after the success of Charenga, which was, you know, up top, y'all showed up in numbers, and the numbers never lie that we love to party. anyway, I saw a poster that has Bobby Wine going to Ghana, and he's going to be on a panel of Wati. For Wati? To do Wati? But the whole thing though is the moment that particular image came out, Abana batani kide ku bebe cool. I'm like, what's up? Why are you they dragging bebe cool in this? Why do you guys have to make it look like Bobby Wine is definitely schooling bebe cool? Because everyone is like, ay, you check this one out. He's the one going to give you an award. I won! If I was an organizer and bebe cool won an award, I would definitely call up Bobby Wine to give it to bebe cool. Chichi. All in the name of consolation, all in the name of Tulibasa Jabakulu, all in the name of to each his own opinion. But at the end of the day, these were two brothers. And this is what you people don't understand. Like, yes, Binyuma, when they are at loggerheads, it was really much fun when they kept throwing all these diss tracks to each other and everything. But you people, let us first sit down and understand the fact that these are two grown-up men. Okay, bagezako masinike busimisa amanyo, bite down, greet, and just like, kwa wadiyo. Thank you. And then to deliver that, I'm trying to find a way where these two can actually have a conversation without us, the outside people, trying to decide which team they should be on. How would Bebe Cool's acceptance speech go? Would he turn around and say, thank you, my brother, Bobby Wine. I'd like to take this moment. Do you see him doing that? Or do you think he'll go like, get me the award, and then he stands like, yo, thank you for loving me, and Bobby Wine is going to just be standing there at the stage like, dude, I made this happen. No, you didn't! Remember when I sat here and I told you, so now Emma Carlos is with Rhythm Empire, the Chibichi, Achukwasa Ganyize, yo. Yeah, he was there for only a month. Naji Nwa, Naji Sula. Did he get the money? What did he do? Naji Sula. Like, jetu wakano teke, wajoti ya mochi intu. No, she made him for 1 month. No, she saba aguruka chonane chifane chigwane wali. And before Rhythm Empire, kali kalenzi chike yali hata niso kumanijinga. Simanya zero. Akuna kwa ya kamanijingi na mwezi. In the strong mwezi guawe. And those are, they were like 3 weeks. He managed him for 3 weeks. And in those 3 weeks, ya muli ya na amu nyuabyo na. Sende nezi guwana ona. Ya musuri na omu mwiki eze sana. Like, I'm trying to understand. And then when we ask the right people, like people who are close to Khalifa Aganaga, like I told you, the game was on us. They keep playing pretend that they're not friends, clearly. We was the one they were fooling, and we were fooled, all right. So apparently, Emma Carlos has seen Khalifa Aganaga. I'm like, not bad. I mean, that they're friends. No, what's your idea? I'm a banja in a man. I'm a nika ba mu banja dad. Yeah? Ziria is already and wizo performance ya gana. Izo twazita, ulaba chaga na hekati ya adisa mutita papa wali. Te azisa suna tata wa. Bana ya chaga mbusa suna sente zote bauza. Yone wakuala yuko wakati tetuja kufandinga. Not every artist has to smoke weed or do crack or do all these weird things. Some artists just love the music and you know, their bodies are their temples. But I'm just asking chaga. Since 1991, ori kutugende tukole. Wako zeyo mmeka, wache chintuto chita. Chite, even if it is love for the music, chite, take a minute. Kuba chiganye, bubu, chiganye. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I'm out. Catch you again tomorrow. It will be a Thursday, and I want to take a minute out. I never say nice things about Winnie Waji, but ooh, Matala is the. I can't cuss on national television, but that song, Winnie Boo Boo, that song is life. Have you listened to it, bro? Matala. Oh, Winnie Nwaji. Wabale fumba mama, josiri kidenga kabinga kali wano kazanya tepo. Kabadeke ya gala, ngakali yako kakali sabutite kapapa. Mama kulika, yo wabale kuda, cause this song is fire.